Hey folks, Jonathan here. Heading to another wreck. This one's another rollover. I've got quite a few rollovers this year already, and should be rolling up on here real soon, so we'll check it out and see what we got. Hopefully I can film this one. We'll see how it goes. We got it out, loaded up, and all that good stuff. Anyway, just wanted to mention something that happened to me the last snowstorm that kind of sort of having trouble getting it out of my head. Let's put it that way. You know, if somebody's in a bad spot and, you know, you're worried about somebody else coming around and turning and hitting them, or you're worried about somebody sliding into them, and, you know, you're driving a record, you know, even if it takes a little bit of time, I usually try to help them out, you know, not for financially, money or not, you know. I had a cop tell me one time that I was just out there trying to make a bunch of money, and that kind of bothered me, because I never was like that, and I'm not like that now. But what happened? I was on a back road, and I come up on a little car that was nosed into the ditch, and it was on a two-lane road, and the whole back end of the car, about the back half of the car, was actually in the road. And I was coming from the other direction, and I've seen it plenty, but there was a turn, you know, on the other side of him, and if somebody came around that turn, it was still slick everywhere. And, you know, people panic, they lock the brakes, and they usually go sliding the same way that the car did that, you know, that is already in the ditch. And I've seen that a lot. But, so anyway, I, you know, rolled the window down, and the boy was trying to get it out. You can see him with some sticks and stuff. And, probably, you know, mid-20s, early 20s. And I asked him if he would like for me to drag him out of there. And of course, he said he didn't have any money. And I said, well, that wasn't why I was asking. So anyway, I went up the road a little piece, turned around and come back. And didn't think much about it. Pulled the cable out, hooked to him, drove forward, drug the car out, and got him, you know, over on the side of the side a little bit off the road anyway, where he could get unhooked and everything. And when I walked back to the car and I unhooked, I walked up beside the car on the passenger side back seat was a baby that couldn't have been much older than newborn, and in a car seat, strapped in good, bundled up good, but that was what someone would have hit if they come around that turn. And the only thing I kept thinking was, what if I hadn't stopped? And I was really reluctant to, you know, I was on the way to another call, and I was reluctant to, you know, stop. And I thought about it, and I said, you know, I'm kicking myself in the butt for not, you know, that should have been something that was automatic. It shouldn't have been something I had to sort of play in my head as whether I was going to stop or not. That's sort of the part that bothers me, because if I hadn't stopped and something would have happened, I'm not saying I would have known about it, but, you know, if I had, I'd never been able to live myself. So anyway, if you see somebody that needs something, need to think about it there a little bit. Just go on and take care of it. Anyway, I appreciate everybody watching, and we'll see what else happens in this circus here I live in. All right, bye.